Hi, I'm Rosemary Frank with the City Channel. You'll never guess where I am today. I'm with Dave Sorrell at the Wastewater Treatment Plant. Join us for a tour. I'm here with Dave, and we are on the dredge on top of the sludge lagoon. And Dave's going to tell us a little bit more about what happens here at the Wastewater Treatment Plant.
Well, here at the plant, we collect all the wastewater that's generated in the city and in some parts of Boone County, and then we treat the water, remove the nasty stuff so that it can be safely released to the environment without causing any harm.
Sounds good. Well, let's go learn more about the process.
All right, I'd be happy to show you. This is the screen room at the pump station. And this is the first place that the water enters the plant. It goes through these bar screens where large pieces of debris are removed from the wastewater. Could be anything from diapers to toys.
Gosh, sounds like a treasure chest.
There's been money found here as well. From here, it gets pumped up into the plant to begin the treatment process. And we've got six new pumps if you'd like to go see the pumps.
Sounds good. Let's go.
Let's go. All right, these are the six new pumps that we've had put in as part of our plant project. These pumps allowed us to have a greater pumping capacity. They'll each pump about 15 million gallons a day. And they got new 200 horsepower motors on each one. We've put in four different odor control units or odor reduction units. One component is right here. When the water goes through the bar screen, it goes into what's called a wet well where it sits until it can be pumped into the plant. One of the wet wells is right here. There's one on each side of this pump station. They're about 60 feet deep. And before the new construction was done, these were just open to the atmosphere so that that wonderful smell from the sewage could just emanate up into the atmosphere. We've covered them and air is actually pulled through this unit. It goes out through that pipe over to some canisters that are full of activated carbon that remove hydrogen sulfide and other compounds that produce unpleasant odors. All right, Rosemary, these are the two of the odor reduction units that we have here at the plant. These two are actually taking the air off the wet wells where we saw the cover just a minute ago. Air goes through here, goes through activated carbon inside these vessels where most of the unpleasant odors get absorbed, and then it gets released through the top.
As part of the improvements out here at the Wastewater Treatment Plant, they are actually automating some of the systems. Can you tell me about that?
Well, this is an operator interface, and it's part of our SCADA system that controls parts of the process. Prior to any of this being put in, everything was more or less manually operated by the operators. This allows us to set different things to automatically happen. For instance, right now I can change this to an automatic valve, and it'll split the flow equally between the two trains that are in service.
Okay.
Just as simple as pushing a button.
What else can it do?
You can just use it to monitor the status of different things. You can see that this unit's running. This one's stopped just by the color. Red's running, green is stopped. You can change with the set points the amount of time that different units run each time they come on.
What are the benefits to the system?
Well, one of the benefits of putting in a SCADA system is it tracks all the history of everything that's happened. So you have trends on plant performance and on different, well, just motor run times to help with maintenance schedules. And then the automation also eliminates the need for somebody to remember to do something over and over again or relying on somebody to actually physically go do it where it can do it by itself. Does that make any sense?
It sure does.
Okay.
All right, where are we headed next? Wow, what do we have here?
This is our grit dumpster. Once the grit's removed, it gets put in this dumpster. We take it out to the other dumpster and it goes to the landfill. Like I said, it's lots of small solid pieces that don't biologically break down in the process. You know, for instance, the bubble gum. This is our new grit facility. And when the water comes from the pump station where we were at a moment ago, this is the first place it comes as part of the process. And it comes up here, gets into one of these basins where the grit falls out, and it goes through that machine we looked at just a little bit ago. It goes to the landfill. The water from here then goes into these two basins, and these are our primary treatment basins. where the majority of the heavier solids falls out of the water. Those get pumped to our digesters, and the water goes on to the aeration basins. And we can go down and look at the aeration basin now if you'd like.
All right, let's go.
All right, watch your step.
Dave, where are we now? Because to me, it looks like a huge chocolate bubble bath.
I wouldn't recommend bathing in it. These are our new aeration basins. And like our old ones, they do remove all the organic pollutants in the water and break them down so that it can be cleaned up and discharged. But these also have a cell that doesn't have air added to it that allows them to be able to remove the ammonia from the water, which is a pollutant. You've heard of the Gulf hypoxia issue, and produces a much cleaner water for discharge to the environment. And the other part of the improvement here is we got rid of our mechanical aerators and we have these fine bubble diffusers. So instead of just chopping the water up to add the oxygen, actually we can control the amount of air in there. It works for a lot more efficient process.
You know, all of a sudden I'm kind of thirsty. You got any marshmallows to go with this chocolate?
I don't think you'd like this chocolate. But if you're thirsty, I could get you a glass of water. This is the treated effluent that leaves the plant. It's been completely through the process, and it leaves the plant, and then it goes down to our wetland treatment units, where it gets a little bit more secondary treatment, and then it gets discharged to Eagle Bluff Conservation Area. There's a lot going on, 24 hours a day, every day of the year.
All right, are we done, or is there another place to go?
I think we're finished.
Well,
we can go get that hot chocolate.
Let's go.
Dave, thanks for taking us on a tour of the wastewater treatment plant. I think it was nice that we were able to show the viewers what happens here. I know I learned a lot.
I hope you enjoyed it.
I sure did. Cheers. After enjoying my hot chocolate and sludge bar at the wastewater treatment plant, I thought I would join Steve Sapp. He's a public information specialist for the Public Works Department. Good morning.
How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks for joining us.
You're very welcome. Thank you.
Well, Steve, I'd like to know if you could give us some more information. Tell us about the wastewater treatment plant. I know that the last expansion was in 1983.
Well, the last expansion in 1983 was when we really ramped up wastewater treatment facilities in general. You know, it hasn't been that long ago that I can remember when Columbia was dotted by over 75 open-air lagoons where our wastewater treatment went. Now we have a modern plant and have had since 1983. So today we have a modern wastewater treatment facility, and these improvements are going to help us meet EPA clean water standards throughout 2020. And then the plant is being constructed in such a manner that we will be able to do additions to the plant, add additional treatment, upgrade current treatment facilities and so forth in a way that we don't have to go back and actually tear out work that we're doing today. So our goal was during the design was to make sure that this plant is expandable, if you will, so that as clean water quality standards change, we can meet those clean water quality standards without tearing out old and putting in completely new. We can just simply make an addition to the plant.
I understand that you all received a grant?
We did receive a grant of approximately $625,000 through Energize Missouri, and that goes with several other grants that were received and of course some bonds that were issued and those were voter approved earlier on. So the total cost of this project is through the design and through the build is roughly $63 million. Of course, there will be some changes that take place in that as we near completion.
Steve, you know, I'm not sure our residents really know just how important our wastewater treatment plant is to the city of Columbia.
Well, it's truly a gem, and you're right. Most people don't even think about what happens to that water that I use when I brush my teeth, when I flush the toilet, take a shower, do the dishes. Where does it go? And we've got an up-to-date modern plant and it's getting the modernization features in it that you know we're talking about to make it even better. And you know we knew that ammonia in the water was one of the issues that we needed to correct and one of the major upgrades to the plant right now is treating that ammonia. So you know as we treat the water at the plant and then we discharge it into the Eagle Bluffs wetlands and it gets treated again before it goes into the river, those are things that people don't think about. And we want them to be aware that, you know, thanks to their efforts and thanks to their funding for this, they should be very proud that they have a modern, up-to-date wastewater treatment plant that is actually treating water and making it livable for all of us, not only here in Columbia, but really throughout the world.
All right, well, thank you for joining us, Steve.
Thank you very much.
As you can see, it's a dirty job, but someone has to professionally do it. I'm Rosemary Frank with the City Channel. For more information on the wastewater treatment plant, please visit our website, gocolumbiamo.com. Thank you for joining us. Oh my goodness. Dave, I've never seen anything like this before. What is this?
This is just your standard job site portable toilet.
Wow. That's amazing.